sincerely thank you all for attending this occasion of my book release. I also thank my publisher, Online Gatha. My special dedication to my mother, enjoying whose affectionate company during the course of writing will always be the most memorable part of my life. Because since soon after I finished the writing, her finite being merged with the infinite. It was then only that I realized that she was just not just my mother, she was also my living God. She was my inspiration, as she was the one who recognized the spirituality within me and my inclination towards literature and writing. Because being a doctor, I just thought of the hospital, my patients and so on, but never realized what lay deep within me. Always, she was the one who used to tell me never to quit writing. So the credit goes to her who tapped my inner spirituality. Since I'm a devotee, whatever I wrote was an expression of my innermost heartfelt feelings for my Lord Shiva, who is the sole reason and definitely the inspiration behind all my efforts. It was his divine force only that made me write all of this. So I would always say that I did not write this. He was the one who wrote this. I was just a medium. That's all. He wrote through me. The theme of my book is expressing the divine love of Lord Shiva for his beloved and dearest devotee Gauri, as well as the unconditional pure love, devotion and surrender of Gauri, who is the greatest devotee and also lover of Lord Shiva and his divine consort too. As you all know, she resides in the left part of his body. She is the left half of his body, and she is the only one who has been given this opportunity. I mean, this the biggest this biggest blessing by God. That means you can imagine how high and how great her devotion must be towards God. That God has given her this respect, this much of respect. Through this deepest expression of her love, she gives a fascinating glimpse of what in reality is true divine love and how anyone, any person who sincerely wills can develop it only and only by God's grace. But the effort is a must. Without effort, God's grace doesn't come. That is true. This book emphasizes the beauty, significance and necessity of divine love and devotion in a very interesting way by an enchanting narration of the pastimes of Shiva and Gauri, who lovingly show us the path towards spirituality through their divine love. Here, it can be seen how transcending the boundaries of space and time, Gauri's pure love overcomes all difficulties and odds of this worldly life, thus becoming a burning example for humanity of the highest love that each and every soul can practically achieve and feel as well. I'm sure that this book will definitely take the readers too on their own spiritual journey, as they will gradually go through this book and they will feel inner happiness, peace and contentment within themselves. Because life is very short and little time we have in this human lifetime to reach him and to love him, so that we may attain the real and only goal of human birth, that is God realization. And pure love and devotion is the only and only way to experience the enchantment of divine love. Time has come now that instead of the worship place, this loving form of our God must be established directly inside our hearts, because that is the place he actually resides in, being the only one who in reality is our own and none else. Well, I would like to conclude with this small poem that I wrote for my mother. Ma, tum har pal dhadakti ho mujhme, prem ban basti ho is dil mein, mehsoos kiya hai ye maine jab se, dekha saakshat ishwar ko tumne, kaise karun tumhara main shukriya, jo ye jeevan hai tumne diya, un khoobsurat se palon ko maine, jo tumhare is komal sneh se, sheetal karti mamta ki narm chhaya tale beparwah hokar jiya, mehsoos kiya hai ye maine jab se, देखा साक्षात ईश्वर को तुमने, माँ तुम हर पल धड़कती हो मुझ में, प्रेम बन बसती हो इस दिल में. एंड फाइनली आई वुड लाइक टू एंड